So excited to say that we're bringing Science with Hazel to the laboratory. I'm joined by Emilia, who's going to be helping with all the experiments, and she's just going to tell you a little bit about herself.
Hi, my name is Emilia. I am a lab technician. I work in this school, Sancton Wood School in Cambridge. I am also a STEM ambassador. I have also an Instagram page, which is called emilia.science, where I put all my experiments and videos and just to make kids interested in science.
In this third video, Emilia and I are going to continue our examination of group one metals, this time looking at the reaction of potassium with water. Now, potassium is more reactive than both lithium and sodium, so we would expect a more vigorous reaction.
Okay, so I'm going to place some drops of universal indicator in the water.
Universal indicator has turned green because obviously water is neutral.
Now I'm going to take the potassium, and because they are stored in paraffin oil, I'm going to dry up all the oil with filtering paper. It's very soft.
Yeah, extremely soft, isn't it? We only need a tiny amount. It's so reactive. Whoa! Fantastic, we've got the lilac flame, which is characteristic of potassium reacting with water, an extremely vigorous reaction. The potassium has skidded across the surface of the water, it floats, it eventually dissolves, and crucially, not only has hydrogen gas been given off, but we can see that our solution has turned a very dark blue colour. That's due to the strong alkali solution produced by the potassium hydroxide. So to summarise, potassium reacts with water, forming potassium hydroxide plus hydrogen.